Humans have been breeding plants to meet our needs for generations. The College of Agriculture as a whole has a mission statement: feed more people. We need to develop the technologies to keep up with the food demands. And so that's why we have to have proprietary technologies and infrastructure that support that. So that's where this facility gives the researchers an opportunity to develop that. Most of these houses here we are replicating a summer afternoon, 14-hour days, 95 in the middle of the day. I'm trying to recreate what's happening in the field indoors year-round.
Maybe the disease resistance is coming from the waxes that are on these plants. I mean, if you look at this plant, maybe it's a little bit waxier. You know, it's got a little more, we call it bloom or wax level.
I am one of two corn breeders for the state of Texas. My overarching goal is to increase the economic and environmental sustainability of agriculture. The most effective way to do that is through plant breeding, so genetically improving the crop. We could really use this facility to do more of a deep dive into individual plants and look at how disease is affecting the plants. Just like some of us were a lot more susceptible to COVID than others, some of those plants are much more susceptible to northern corn leaf blight or leaf rust.
Currently, in many greenhouses here at Texas A&M, you could walk in at any time and there will be an assembly line of students, grad students and undergrads with measuring tapes and scales taking data. The best that that team could do would be once a day. With this technology, we could take those same data points probably up to six times a day without ever stopping, without even disturbing the plant. We are the first one to use a robotic arm. So in every other facility in the United States, the plant is taken to a photo booth and the data points are taken. That limits the plant how big it can be because the booth is only a certain size. The second part of that is you're disturbing that plant by moving it.
The robotic arms help us because the most laborious part of what we do is in measuring things. The robotic arms are set so that they can scan all these plants automatically. We think we can get hundreds of measurements from those scans. With this automated system, you know, the barrier for each measurement is, you know, almost zero. There's very little cost, both in terms of people's time or in terms of money.
These are the exact same arms that you're seeing on the assembly lines in our automotive industry. A robotic arm is very similar to a human arm, and it has the same movements and motions that we do, but it doesn't get tired. We can put any instrument that we see necessary on the end of that robotic arm to do a repeatable task over and over and over.
We develop artificial intelligent approaches to analyze images. I'm able to merge my artificial intelligence knowledge with their plants in order for us to develop this useful product. We can collect high resolution images, and then from there, we do some pre-processing to clean up the images, dealing with some kind of artifacts or things that might not be well suited for the data. The end product is we want to have some kind of like user interface, kind of like an app where people can, you know, take images from the facility here and they can say, oh, I want to get the length of this plant or get some kind of useful information, or is there some kind of disease that's present in the plant? What we're trying to do is trying to mimic how we as humans see. And so part of my work is trying to figure out how can we identify those interesting features or information that we cue in as humans in order to let the AI model know, okay, there might be some issue with the plant. I'm really excited to really have an impact, because for me, I never just wanted to get, you know, stuck in the weeds of just doing, you know, research, but really doing research that makes a meaningful impact for society as a whole. We want to be able to leverage these AI tools in order to achieve these goals that will be beneficial for our society.
We used to have to go to the office to check our emails. Now we just pick up our phone and check our email. It's the same thing with some of that data that these scientists are looking for. If they could get that data faster, they can develop the technologies faster. Without the infrastructure, they cannot develop the technologies that we're going to need in the future. People want to work within infrastructure that is high quality, so they can focus on their research and not on where they're going to do their research. Quality infrastructure drives quality research.